Welcome to Windows 10 System Tray and Action Center, presented by the Buffalo and Erie County Public Library. You will find the system tray on the bottom right-hand side of the taskbar. In the system tray, you will typically see the Action Center, Date and Time, Volume Control, your Internet connection, Battery Status, and a little upwards-pointing arrow for hidden icons. Hidden icons just tucks away some of those processes running in the background, such as your antivirus or USB ejection. Notice that when you hover over something in Windows, you will often see a pop-up telling you what that item is. Use your primary button to click on an empty area of the desktop to exit hidden icons. Windows 10 comes with built-in mail and calendar apps, which you can find in the Start menu. If you set up and use the Calendar app, you'll be able to primary click on the date and time in the system tray and view your agenda. If you don't wish to see it, simply click on Hide Agenda. Clicking on an empty area of the desktop or on the date and time will hide the calendar. To the right of the date and time, you'll see a little icon that looks like a speech bubble. It could either be blank and empty, or it can be white with lines and a number next to it. Clicking on this icon opens up the Action Center. This area is the equivalent of a notification center on your smartphone or tablet. At the top, you'll see notifications from various apps, for example, email messages, antivirus alerts, and more. When you hover over each of these notifications, you'll notice an X and an arrow in the upper right-hand corner of each one. Clicking on the arrow will give you options for that particular notification. Clicking the X will close that notification. Using your secondary button or right-clicking on a notification will give you further options for controlling how often and what type of notifications appear in your Action Center. In this case, clicking on the Go to Notification setting in an email notification takes us to the notification settings in the Mail app. Reviewing these settings can be invaluable if you receive a lot of emails or have a lot of email addresses and you just feel like the Action Center is just too cluttered and too chaotic. To close the settings, simply click on the red X in the upper right-hand corner. If you would simply like to not see notifications from that program anymore, you can go ahead and select Turn Off Notifications from this group. The bottom of the Action Center is filled with squares called tiles. These particular tiles are called Quick Actions and should be familiar to you if you've ever used a smartphone or a tablet. They offer quick and easy access to a variety of common settings, such as quiet hours, your Wi-Fi connection, and more. Because Windows 10 is designed to be used on a variety of touchscreen and non-touchscreen devices, these tiles are designed for touching with a finger, although you can primary click on them if your device is not a touchscreen device. Speaking of touchscreen devices, it's important to pay attention to the tablet mode Quick Action in the Action Center. This tile will appear whether or not you have a touchscreen device, and if you click on it, it will convert the screen to touchscreen mode. If that happens, simply click on the tablet mode tile again, and then click on an empty area of the desktop, and everything will return to normal. At the bottom left-hand corner of the desktop is a search bar. We can use this search bar to find other settings for the Action Center. Typing in notifications will allow me to access the settings for both what items appear in the Quick Actions area, as well as notification settings. Here, I can rearrange the order in which Quick Actions appear, as well as removing and adding them. Notice, down at the bottom, I see a list of applications that I can receive notifications for, and I can turn the mail notifications back on if I had changed my mind about turning them off. Thank you for watching this tutorial video provided by the Buffalo and Erie County Public Library.